Mabuhay, Kamustika, welcome. How are you? This is Bob from Love Beyond the Sea. Is my Phil-Am marriage what I thought it would be? While I have made a video about how my marriage to a Filipina has been easier than I have expected, this one is about the general idea of whether or not it has been the way I thought it would be. Has it gone the way I was expecting? Please subscribe to Love Beyond the Sea for videos to help a foreign man interested in a Filipina all the way to marrying her and after that. I encourage marriage to anyone, and a lot of things I say would apply to any woman. I just happened to marry a woman from the Philippines. I cover the whole gamut in this channel. Comments, they're always welcome, and please get notifications for future videos. I am sure someone will see this that is curious about marrying a woman from the Filipinas, even a younger one. They have heard about other men marrying Filipinas and wonder if it could be for real, if it could happen for them. Well, it did for me. I want to make marriage great again, and that includes for you. Other than the reason Filipinas are beautiful and feminine and like it that way, I have heard now and then how they make good wives. That's what I was looking for, but was not able to find someone. I had not considered going so far away to look for a wife and considered about 50 miles to be my limit since I wanted to be able to spend a lot of time with them. However, I wanted this good wife they talked about. I married a Filipina in May of 2015, although I only started to seriously look for them about that time. Let me compare my expectations with reality. Let's start with family culture. Family culture. Marrying someone from a different culture would be different than what I was used to or had even thought about. But actually, you know, it hasn't really been that much different or caused any problems. About the only difference has been that she spends ample time chatting with family back home, as she should. They're almost 10,000 miles away. And I've been there four times, and I know just exactly how far away that is. Since I understand what this would be like, you know, that's fine. I'm good with that. Excuse me. I can't think of any other way. The culture itself has been an issue, but if we considered my wife helping her family so much by working here, a cultural thing, well, that wouldn't have been a surprise to me. What would be a surprise is that I have fallen in love with her family, and I want to help them as much as I can. Now, simply marrying a woman from the Philippines by itself has been what I thought it would be, or even better. I wasn't expecting trouble, but thought that there would be some adjustments for both of us to make, maybe bigger than they have been. I have not had become a different person with her. I have been able to just be myself. Haven't had to change anything. My wife, being from another culture, hasn't changed anything over here in the United States, other than I have added, you know, karaoke to my experiences. If you dare, you can see some of that in the playlist called Just Us. That is where the two of us can be seen together. And there are almost 200 videos there now, so that's quite a few. Age gap, expectations. Well, what can I compare this to? Nothing really. I was very curious about this, and I had gone 30 years without so much as a dating relationship, so I would have wondered how this would go, since I, you know, had I married a same-age woman here in the United States, I mean, I would have been curious about that. But now, throw in somebody being 27 years younger, wow, what was that going to be like? What would the intimacy be like? And many men are looking for younger women, by the way. How would I treat a younger woman? How would she treat me? Would she want to be intimate with me? How would she respond in public to being married to an older man? You know, what would she tell her friends? How would other women treat her? What would be the response of people that know me? There is much appeal in marrying a younger woman, but I wonder how many men think about things like I mentioned that go hand in hand with an age gap. There doesn't seem to be a stigma among Filipinas that actually marry an older foreigner, as they are likely mature enough to know what they're getting into. Now, our age gap, I said, was 27 years, but I mean, some have 30 and 40 years. It's not like they can't talk to other Filipinas who have older husbands and, you know, learn some things, get some ideas. My wife will defer questions about my age when asked back to me. And surprisingly, no one has taken her up on that. Socially speaking, my wife and I have spent time visiting other, you know, Philam couples and non-Philam couples where the age difference hasn't been a reason for anyone to be uncomfortable. I honestly feel like we've been treated, you know, just like anyone else, you know, if she had been similar age. My wife has been embraced by my family, my friends, my church. Perhaps people are intrigued by us because it is unusual, but I have not gotten the impression anyone thinks of me as a cradle robber. I have great respect and admiration for my wife, and I hope that shows, you know, that other people can see that. I'm going to link the playlist I have for a younger wife in the description box. You know, I've made 850 videos by now, and I don't make a big deal about this, but from time to time, we'll comment, since I know the age gap issue is on the minds of many foreign men. I have 26 videos so far in that playlist for you. I don't think I consider my wife younger, you know, consciously. At least, you know, not that I'm aware. She is my wife. That I am aware. My best friend, my life companion, and somebody I feel responsible for. She is almost 33 now. Incredible, since she was 26 when we married. And that is really hard to believe. Guys, make the most of your time. It waits for no one. You older guys know what I'm talking about. Now, how about short dating and engagement? Quick marriage. We got married real quick. Has that been a disaster? There is a reason most men don't marry someone from another country in just 54 days. Yet my wife accepted my proposal with the trust that we would take our marriage seriously and continue to get to know each other after marriage. I wanted a Christian woman. That was the only must-have on my list. Obviously, I wanted a woman I was attracted to. That goes without saying. What has surprised me was how well my wife and I got along right from the start, in person. When I flew down there to meet her on, probably after a month of, you know, of talking to her, I've always felt very comfortable and relaxed with her. After being alone for so long, I wondered if I would feel awkward with meeting someone that I was committed to marry that I hadn't even met yet in person. However, there was no nervousness. That still surprises me. I think we are very happy with our marriage, and we are growing. It's a marathon, not a sprint, and I think you have to look at it that way. People have known each other for years, then got married, and it didn't work out. So the key isn't how long you've known each other or all of the knowledge you've acquired about each other. I wanted a Christian woman. She wanted a Christian man. We got married. I had all those years being single to work on knowing what is required to be a good husband. Then I finally got the chance to use it, so I didn't feel unprepared for marriage. I just lacked experience in dating. As it turned out, I didn't even need it. I am very committed to my Filipino wife, and I want to do everything I can to protect her, provide for her, make her dreams come true. I have found this to be a very rewarding mindset. I guess I could say that I am surprised there haven't been any unpleasant discoveries, ones that would, you know, make me regret marrying her so soon. You know, she is the woman I thought she was, only better. We have worked through the usual tussles you'll experience in a marriage, guaranteed. Sometimes nothing comes easy as you are in new situations together. Other times things go smoothly. What else is new? It's kind of like anything else. How about home life, expectations of home life? Well, I had never been married before, I can say that. What would it be like at home after being alone, single for so long? What would we do together? Would we argue about stupid things? How would we deal with generational gap differences? How would we divide the household chores? You know, would I lose my temper a lot? Would we argue about money? And so on. My wife prides herself in being a good cook. keeping a clean, neat, organized house. I love it. Every single place in it, even the CR of the bathrooms, you know, we both like an organized place to live. And I'm glad for that. Any man and woman living under the same roof are going to experience disagreements, say things they shouldn't say once in a while, need to ask for forgiveness and to forgive the other person. We haven't been immune to that. I am pleased that we have learned to make up relatively quickly. We haven't had quarrels that go on for days or long periods of tempo. I will include a video for you about that tempo that explains what I think is the best way to handle the silent treatment. We hate it when we are at odds with each other, and it really bothers me. It is just so disruptive. It is normal to expect to argue about stupid stuff initially, let's say first 2 years, as we get used to being around each other and try to live in harmony. I believe we have grown together over the time we have been married, grown closer, not grown apart. I pray regularly for her and with her and for our marriage and for me to be a good husband, and I enjoy praying for her. I allow my wife to spend as much time as she needs on Facebook or Messenger with the family. We watch movies together. We have done some traveling. I'm in my second year of retirement. That gives me more time to work on Love Beyond the Sea and make podcasts for Casting Beyond the Sea. Our home life is good. My wife works works full time and some overtime, and has made a quick impression here as an employee and gotten some promotions, for which I am very proud of her. Now she has added some school, which is basically full time too. Thankfully, that's not going to be forever. I must remember, she may live a long time after I am gone. Just today, she got her car title in the mail as she paid off her new SUV from 4 years ago. I mean, that's a big, big deal. She needs to pursue what is important to her. So I will add a link to a couple of playlists I have called Help for Harmony and Laying the Foundation of Your Marriage to a Filipina. How about the very long distance relationship? This is another area I had no previous experience in, and it didn't last long. I mean, it can be fun and exciting, but you know, if you want to get married, you know, you need to do something about that. Not just have a, you know, like a pen pal or somebody to talk to on camera, because I think eventually that's going to get boring for the Filipina. When I married her so fast, I wasn't thinking, you know, too far ahead about the long immigration process, although a quicker marriage makes for a faster reunion and the start of your lives together if she comes to be with you. The use of Skype and Viber helped me to be able to decide to propose to her in only 18 days because it allowed us to focus on getting to know each other in a more condensed, intentional way. If I had been dating someone from America, it is possible the process would have gone much slower, partly due to that's just the way it tends to work over here, and because, you know, we could do more things together, which would really only serve to focus on enjoying our time together, avoiding any potentially negative conversations and situations. But when communicating so far away, I used that time to start out expressing why I was on the dating site Christian Filipina, why I needed a wife, what kind of woman I was looking for, and an idea of what being married to me would be like. When a guy joins an international dating site, one requiring a paid membership, he isn't on there to pass the time. Probably unlike the American dating sites that I had tried, the Filipinos were serious about meeting someone to marry them. This, coupled with not being able to be shoulder to shoulder with the Filipinas, made for a more serious attempt to find a wife. We weren't able to go on, you know, dates and avoid causing conflict, you know, by being ourselves and the fear of being serious about marriage too soon and scaring the other away. We got down to business quickly. She was there to get married, I was there to get married, and we got married. Still are. And happy about it. And I had a lot to do with that, since the guy should manage the pace of the relationship. I was aggressive, she didn't mind. You don't have to move as fast as I did. I've got videos on that. You know, you have to decide what pace is good for you. You may never know everything about your wife before you get married. I wouldn't count on that. Anyone is going to only reveal what they are comfortable with at the time. A very long distance relationship can take more time or less time than a domestic one, and it can get you together more quickly if you approach it seriously. Filipinas want to get married. Young guys, young men, saying they can't find women today, aren't looking in the right place. Marriage has been better than I expected, as I didn't expect to feel so strongly about her. With that feeling growing, even after and during our marriage, the relationship should continue to develop after marriage. That is just the start of a different stage. I mean, I really love my amazing Isa. When your best friend is your wife, you have the best of life. I am glad I didn't give up on that. I will link the playlist called Christian Filipina, which contains a lot of videos about dating a Filipina. I hope you'll click on my affiliate link for that. That'll be in the description. I have to admit that being married has been even better than I thought it might be with my love beyond the sea.